Hello, everybody. Well, the last time you saw me turning, it was a very green chunk of box elder, a beautiful flame box elder. It had about 26% moisture content, if I recall correctly. Stay tuned to the end of the video, and I'll give you some results on that after a week of in-the-house drying. Anyways, this week, the opposite side of the moisture spectrum. Everything you see turned on this video is kiln-dried cherry. Stabilized somewhere between 7 and 9% moisture content. And there sure is a big difference. Turning green is so much easier. But cherry, it turns nice. I'm not complaining. This week I'm doing something that I've never done before, and that's making a set of dishes. I'm making a total of 7 different items, but I'm only going to show the making of 4 of them. One big bowl, one smaller bowl like you see there, and then a couple of serving tools. Also, some things I've never made before. So this video is a little bit longer than usual. I'd say about twice as long as my usual video. I hope you enjoy it. I won't be running my mouth so much during, just occasionally. Lots of really nice, relaxing tool sounds. I'll be mounting these on the truck using a woodworm screw, like you see here. The reason I drew circles on all of these pieces was because originally I was going to use a faceplate, and that was my way of centering the faceplate. But the woodworm screw is just a much easier way to do it, and it's very secure. The wood's nice and solid. My first step is to make this bowl nice and round, and then I'll work on the bottom of the bowl, and then I'll finish the final shape of the outside and get it finished before I flip it around. Same process with all 5 bowls that I'm making in this project. And here I'm marking for the mortise. And between those two marks is the foot of the bowl. And in the very center is where my little marking badge goes. So the duct tape is on my hand because the band-aid that was there wouldn't stick. Too much dust. So, you know, seemed like the right thing to do. Anyways, I sanded up to 500 and then I used some denatured alcohol to raise the grain. And then I resanded at 500. And then I used Axe abrasive paste and then Axe polish as a finish on this bowl. Food safe, mineral oil, carnauba wax, and beeswax. Easy to use. Not sponsored. I just really like the stuff. But that's what I used on all the bowls, inside out, and the tools that I made. So much dust that the duct tape failed. So I just put a glove on. And eventually I think I just gave up on the whole idea. Just trying to hide a little burn that I gave myself when I was camping outside in a snowstorm. And that's part one complete. Let's take a look at what you've been up to out there. Don Lewis made all these. Gorgeous, gorgeous. Great work, Don. Wilson Stecker made these. Hope I said your name right, Wilson. Really nice work. Just gorgeous. Artistic eye. And Ron Chamberlain made this. This is made from actual parts of a piano. Just gorgeous. Great work, everybody. And I want to take this opportunity to thank all of my subscribers. It's just so humbling to know that so many of you are interested in what I'm doing in my shop. I appreciate each and every one of you. I really do. Now, on to part two, showing one of the four smaller bowls that I made. Same process as before, so I'll stop running my mouth. And now part three.
Well, I forgot to turn the camera on. Sorry.
Well, it took a couple days, but I had a good time doing it. Beautiful natural cherry. I hope you like what I did with it. Let me know what you think. Thanks for watching. I sure appreciate it. God bless and Semper Fi.
I can get it to.
The results of turning green wood thin. After a week, it's stable moisture-wise and only a quarter inch out around.